Hi, my name is Kelly Rosa Bragueto. I am an assistant professor at the Department of Computer Science of the Institute of Mathematics and Statistics of USP, the University of São Paulo. In this short talk, I would like to present to you the Free Libre Open Source Software Competence Center of USP and show how the center has been contributing to the development of high-quality open research software. USP is the largest public university in Brazil, and it is the most prestigious also. The FLOSS Competence Center at USP comprises activities related to education, research, development, and dissemination of free and open source software. The center's primary goal is to foster development, research, and adoption of FLOSS both inside and outside the university by providing for users and developers high-quality resources and expertise on the various topics related to open source software. The university has FLOSS centers in two campuses, in São Paulo City and São Carlos City. The FLOSS Competence Center at São Paulo was founded in 2008. It was initially funded by the University of São Paulo, the Brazilian Innovation Agency, which is a state company under the Ministry of Science, Technology and Innovations, and the Qualypso Project of the European Commission under the Sixth Framework Program. The center's building has auditory, computer labs, study rooms, and professor offices. It's located near the Department of Computer Science. The center offers physical and human resources to support curricular and extracurricular activities for the university students, mainly on topics related to open source software, open hardware, technological innovation, and entrepreneurship. The center organizes and hosts events such as lectures, workshops, conferences, hackathons, and outreach courses. It's an excellent means for the university to communicate with the Brazilian society and software industry. It contributes not only in sharing the technology acquired by our research groups, but also working as a meeting point for students, researchers, and practitioners from our region and abroad. The professors and students associated with the center have a strong background in research on FLOSS and software engineering. Their contributions range from studies about the FLOSS ecosystem to the improvement of open source software development models. Since its creation, the center has been performing a fundamental role in supporting the Brazilian scientific community to embrace openness. The center offers training, consulting, and hosting to researchers from any field of science to promote the production of high-quality open research software. It provides assistance to researchers not only on tools, platforms, and licenses, but also on methodologies, studies, and best practices in software development. Despite its importance and high impact, the center's scope of action is too small, considering Brazil's large extension and inequalities. There is a lack of country-wide open science practical initiatives. There is also a lack of incentives from funding agencies and research institutions, which should provide physical infrastructure, information, and human resources to assist researchers. At the federal level, we can say that the first movement towards open science appeared in 2011, when Brazil started formal initiatives to adopt open government data by creating the law on access to information and co-founding the Open Government Partnership, which now has 77 other signatory countries. The biennial Open Government National Action Plans, which are part of the Open Government Partnership, have raised awareness and commitments to open science, since most of the research in Brazil is developed in public institutions. But it's worth mentioning that Brazil became a leader of the open access movement much before that. Brazil has an open access program recognized as one of the most important in the world, the Scientific Electronic Library Online, Cielo, which was established in 1997. Cielo's publication model has been adopted by 15 other countries in a network that groups more than 1,000 open access journals, which publish an average of 50,000 papers per year. Concerning the management of open research data, coordinated actions started to take shape only more recently. In 2018, the Brazilian Ministry of Science, Technology and Innovations created a working group that to draft the National Policy for Open Science that produced guidelines for research data management in Brazil. In the same year, Brazil adhered to the GoFair initiative by creating the GoFair Brazil Office, hosted by the Brazilian Institute of Information in Science and Technology, which is a research branch of the ministry. The GoFair Brazil is one of the first GoFair national offices established outside Europe. The first active implementation network in operation in Brazil is in the health domains. Other fields are in the process of adherence negotiation. While the national policy is not implemented, a few distributed efforts stand out, mainly on the biggest public research institutions and on the wealthy state funding agencies. The State of São Paulo Research Foundation, FAPESP, is one of the main funding agencies for scientific and technological research in Brazil. FAPESP has been defining policies and fostering initiatives towards open science aligned with what is practiced in other countries. In 2019, FAPESP formalized its open access policy for publications, under which all journal papers that result from FAPESP-funded research must be made publicly available in institutional open access repositories, as long as this does not violate copyright rules. Since 2017, FAPESP requires from researchers data management plans on the submission of project proposals. The data produced in projects funded by FAPESP must be stored in institutional repositories, which should preserve them and make them openly accessible, subjected to the applicable standards and constraints. Also in 2017, FAPESP started a workforce to develop a state network of open research data repositories formed by the 6 public universities of the state of São Paulo, including USP, and other 2 public institutions of research. The repository that gathers research data metadata from the network was launched in 2019. The network infrastructure is also being used to share pseudonymized data of COVID-19 patients, an initiative that contributes to essential research on several countries. For some of its funding lines, FAPESP already requires that all software developed within a funded project be licensed as free software. However, differently from the case of research data, there are no institutional supporting resources, such as guidelines and metadata repositories, to help researchers appropriately develop, preserve, and disseminate their research software. Until now, the sustainability of research software seems not to be part of the discussions of the official working groups. This scenario highlights the importance of reinforcing and replicating the work that the FLOSS Competence Center is doing at the USP. Moreover, it exposes the urgent need for the Brazilian government, the research institutions, and the funding agencies to finance and cooperate to build appropriate infrastructure and establish models and policies to sustain the Brazilian research software. Thank you for your attention, and if you have any doubts, please do not hesitate to contact me.